Let me just get a couple bow samurai here. It doesn't really matter. I'm losing an army. I'm actually trying to break the game again. I was able to break the game yesterday and do a attack on somewhere or other, and you know, I forced a rebellion in this town, and when that happened, I was sent an army to attack it, hoping I'd get a real combat engagement, but you couldn't, unfortunately. Like I said, all this kind of stuff makes a lot of sense. The Yari samurai, you know, good at poking infantry and excellent anti-cavalry, but weak, vulnerable to sword armed infantry, makes perfect sense. And then you've got the Nagata. These guys are kind of versatile infantry, are good in melee and against cavalry. So I kind of like the idea that there's this choice still. This is, you know, the perfect unit. This is the non-perfect unit versus cavalry. Yet again, this unit will do a lot better versus swords than this unit. So if I have to have a secondary line that I know is going to be, you know, called in at some point, it's going to be a lot more versatile. So they do have some units and varieties in there, but not as much to the extent of Medieval 2. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go through all these in a little bit, but let me just finish talking about the units. That they're fairly well designed. They definitely show up well in the game. The detail is amazing, and I'm going to see if I can reload one of the battles in there. I'll probably do a historical battle just to show you guys how miserably I suck at it, because I still have no idea what's going on. And I'll probably use that to finish off this little segment, in fact. But I want to go through all these units now and kind of give you a brief overview. So we're going to start with the archers and compare them to, you know, the basic ones. So you've got the Kosaki Bilbo Ashigaru. So peasants with bows, I guess, is the right way of putting it. And so, can I have two of these up, I wonder? No, I can't. I can click in between them pretty quickly. So you can definitely see the difference is massive. But the upkeep cost isn't that massive. Massively different, at least. So if we go here and here, we can definitely see the samurais are a huge training differential. But these guys cost 300 to recruit. These guys cost 600, so double the recruitment cost. And 70 versus 125. So you're looking at about an extra, well, let's do this, 30, you know, 55 per turn upkeep for an extra unit, which I think is kind of silly, to be honest. If they've got nearly double the stats, and if you look at this, they've got more than double the stats in some locations. Reloading skill, accuracy, armor, morale, about the same speed, actually, which is kind of interesting. You know, there's no reason to get the peasants. I guess if you're in a pinch and you need just some extra meat on the field, yes, go get peasants. Otherwise, not so much. We go over here. We went through the Nagata samurai and the Yari samurai. We can go back here. We do have the Katana cavalry. They're pretty nice. I do like them. They work well and effectively. Yet again, just anything, charge them into anything that doesn't have a pointy end on it, that has, it doesn't have a pointy end, a large stick attached to the pointy end, essentially. Light cavalry, I'm not exactly sure what's going on with all this. I think these guys are better with sustained combat, and these guys are good at charges, but oh, these guys are good versus cavalry. Okay, so the light cavalry is good versus cavalry, but the vulnerable and prolonged melee. That makes perfect sense, sure. Then we have the Yari cavalry. I can't get it because I don't have some kind of dojo built, I'm sure. It looks like they're fairly similar. I'm not too sure here. Okay, so they're just better versions, more heavily armored, and have a better charge bonus and melee attack. So they're just the upgrade version. And yet again, double the recruitment, double the upkeep for that better edge. I guess it's starting to make a little bit more sense. Bow cavalry, if you know your Japanese history, the Japanese actually had some pretty amazing bow cavalry people. In fact, they still have traditions where they do that shit today, which is a little bit confusing, but whatever. All will go with it. So obviously keep these guys away from melee and that kind of stuff. I can definitely imagine them coming into play in multiplayer battles and, a lot of people using them because they're so darn effective at times. They're gonna, a baseline of archers dug in is gonna be better than the cavalry, but that cavalry is just gonna run havoc on your flanks. But still, very cool unit. I couldn't get any because the demo doesn't allow it. Sorry if you hear that crunching noise. One of my favorite units, the Donashi Samurais. Basically, guys with really big swords. And they've got a good charge bonus, so really big sword people, good charge bonus, kind of makes sense, yeah. Then we have the Katana Samurai. I'm not exactly... It looks like they're more heavily armored and actually have a lot better melee defense. So it looks like these are your shock troops and these are your staying fighting troops. Essentially good troops to send in to hit something. Hit and sustained combat while the Donashi will... Yeah, so you send your samurai to the front lines and then your Donashi to the sides. And if I'm screwing up the pronunciation, well, whatever. That's your own fault for listening to this, I say. Then we go here to firebomb people. I never knew they had this, to be honest. I really didn't. I have no idea what they're used for. I'm sure there's something... I'm guessing they're going to be able to... do heavy morale damage. I guess they're kind of grenades. They'd be used against enemy walls and sieges. They make some sense. Very specialized role, though. And obviously they're peasants, so... Everything else is pretty crappy. I think those are all the dojos I could pick up. Construction. Can I even delete this, I wonder? Hold on. Click on this. Burn! What does that come up with? Oh yeah, this is something here. The garrison units, you have an automatic garrison. That makes perfect sense to me. If you remember correctly, in the old days, I don't want to call them old days because they're still, the games are still being played. In the current versions of most Total War games, you have units and then you've got free upkeep units, but you still have to make the units. Now you just have units in there already. Wow, doesn't that make perfect sense? A giant castle doesn't have a normal garrison that you have to assign automatically? Makes perfect sense to me, if you basically get some of my logic. So I really like that. So I'm kind of happy with that. Let me see if I'm just going to burn the dojo, though. Yes, burn the dojo. Next turn. I'm going to get my samurai over to the other end to see if I can do something interesting. Like I said, I have actually beaten the demo. I'm not too worried about throwing you guys off, so we'll see what we can do. You go attack. Sabotage army. Oh, 28-3. Sabotage the gates, why not? And do we get a little video? It looks like our assassinified person failed, or he's setting up for it. I'm not too sure. Let's see what we can build here, though. We actually have quite a few options, thankfully. I'm quite enjoying the options on it. The only thing I'd have to say I don't like so much is... look how small it is. It's taking up that bottom screen, and I can go over it, but it takes a while. And at this resolution, reading that... it's kind of a pain in the arse, actually, to be frank. If I had my mouse over this, I would like this to be instantly larger and in the center of my screen, so I can definitely see what's going on. Maybe someone will patch that in, I'm not too sure, or whatever, but, Archery bow, dojo, Yari drill town, archery dojo, market, so you... I like the idea, it's like... one of the extra buildings you can get. Although the one thing I don't like too much is You only have three structures. I'm guessing the bigger your castle gets, the more structures it can hold or something. But, you know, encampment town. This must be first stepped every... Okay, I'm not too sure. Oh, okay, I get it. Katana Samurai, so I think I can get here that I don't have. I can get the ninjas. Light cavalry. No, and fire throwers. No, nothing really I want to go there. I'm going to try and do the encampment town, because I just haven't seen it before. Oh, and we see the secret police brutally molding my ninja. So it looks like the AI is a little bit better. Okay, no, whatever. I'm not recruiting very much. This demo is going on quite amusingly. I still haven't found a way of breaking it entirely, though. No, can't do that. I should have finished the recruitment of this stuff. Army, yeah. So let me just take my army here. I do have my ninja. Move the guys there. Now, I do want to see... So is this an overall recruitment tab, I wonder? Or is this a recruitment that, Yeah, so I wonder if that's just an overall arcing thing, because I'm not quite sure how that one works yet. Yeah, so it looks like that just builds everything in your towns everywhere. Okay, that kind of makes sense, I guess. I don't see the option to build a watchtower, though, but it looks like you actually get vision of your lands and, you know, a little bit past, but still no watchtowers. That's been in there for ages. I'm kind of surprised they would get rid of that, to be honest. Look over here. I'm going to see if I can take on a battle and, you know, kill one of these guys. Send in a full-on army. Obviously, I'm not going to be able to do very much. And can I... construction? Oh, sod it. I'm just going to build a... thingy here. Not even sure what I'm going to call it yet. Ah! There we go, whatever. Okay, so hold on. This might make sense. No, I refuse. I want you to fight me. I hit the recruitment on my general. Now, if that army moves to my general this turn, and looks like he is doing, and that other unit is coming towards him, that is amazing. I love that fact right there. I didn't even know about that before this video, so totally sprung out of there at me. That I can use my general for recruitment and say, okay, if I select this general, and now if I select my dynamo, dude face, come over here, click on him. Okay, now does he get reinforced as well immediately? I'm just kind of experimenting here. Obviously the demo is way over all that jazz. Okay, first it was 1,000. No, their demands seem to be a little bit jacked, but whatever. So let's see, does anyone move towards my dynamo if I recruit from him as well? I'm just intrigued on this kind of stuff. I'm kind of experimenting while you guys are here as well, so I do apologize. And it does look that way. So that is a pretty cool feature right there. I really like that. You know, I can click on, I can manually do it in each city and then move along, or I can click on my general and click recruitment and then queue up some units that I want in his army specifically. What do I actually need here? Archery dojo. So construction, what do these guys have? Noda Ishii. Huh, interesting. So you do need certain aspects of it, and this guy has stone quarry. I'm not too sure exactly what it does, but it tells you. Okay, that's pretty cool. So I like that feature. You know, you automatically can you can say, okay, well, I'm gonna need this at some point, or you just want to have your generals out and about.